Oh, upstairs, upstairs. Research diary for anti-aging rune. Classified for Pearl's eyes only. Date.
Huh?
Work has finally begun on my anti-aging rune. If all goes to plan, I believe it will effectively reverse the aging process. This technology will enable us to make retired warriors young again, thereby strengthening the Hyrulean army. When Calamity Ganon inevitably returns, we'll be ready. Our offense will be solid, and our defense impenetrable. The need for this tech pains me, but I truly hope to use it to attain everlasting peace for all. Date. The beta version of my anti-aging rune is complete. I have finally added it to the Sheikah slate I made for myself. Oh, she has one. Since I am to be the test subject of this experiment, Simon booted up the rune and directed its rays at my body. After 20 seconds of exposure, I felt extreme fatigue and broke into a fever, forcing us to cease the experiment. Unable to stay awake, I went to bed immediately. Tomorrow I will try to figure out what went awry. Anti-aging experimental trial day 2. My extreme full body fatigue has slightly improved, for which I am grateful. Still, I do not recognize the face in my mirror. My hair is thick again and floor length. My wrinkles, once deep as trenches, have vanished without a trace. It seems the anti-aging effect works. However, I did not expect the reversal to happen so frighteningly fast. This morning I kicked Simon awake and had him run a full physical exam on me. My height, weight, vision, bone density, heart, blood. We tested everything we could, pushing our facility to its limit. Our discoveries were startling. My results were typical of a Sheikah woman in her early 50s. In other words, I reversed my age by more than 70 years in a single night. I can only hope that I do not awaken to find I have the body of a newborn baby. Anti-aging experimental trial day 3. I awoke with an abundance of energy. It has been decades since I slept so well. Upon awakening, I immediately checked the mirror, only to be greeted by a youthful version of myself. According to Simon's examination, I have the body of a Sheikah woman in her 30s. 30 years old. I was around that age when I was first able to continue my research following the Great Calamity. The first thing I did was to try and figure out how to expand the functionality of the Sheikah sensor. I was around 80 years old when that expansion was completed. I intend to bequeath this tech to our sleeping hero. I hope to the gods that he will be able to assist in the destruction of the calamity that swallowed our Princess Zelda whole. Day 4. After today's routine physical, the results show that I have the body of a Sheikah woman in her 20s. I haven't felt this good in a century. This is all taking me back to when the Great Calamity happened. Ganon had been dormant for 10,000 years. Perhaps this power has been building all that time. The slaughter that followed was arbitrary and merciless. The destruction complete. We lost everything. Hyrule Castle, Princess Zelda. Well, perhaps everything was not everything was lost. A youth named Link was brought to me 100 years ago, covered in wounds and on death's doorstep. Link, so young, yet so courageous. He was the youngest knight to have ever been appointed to the Imperial Guard at the Hyrule Castle. He was also a gifted swordsman who was selected as a captain of Princess Zelda's personal guard. I thought his skills would be enough to defeat Ganon in glorious fashion. Since ancient times, the royal family of Hyrule and us Sheikah researchers have had a strong bond. Their pain is our own. We took the swordsman and the Sheikah slate Princess Zelda left behind to the Shrine of Restoration. Resurrection. Although the Slumber of Restoration has not been fully tested, we decided to put the swordsman under to save his life. It was the best we could do. Day 5. I awoke to something horrifying. A scarlet lump scarring my otherwise youthful face. After analyzing this monstrosity, I have come to the conclusion that it was just a pimple. A big one. The results of today's physical exam show that my body and mind have reverted to those of a teenager. I feel like Simon looks at me differently, which irritates me. I got angry when he insisted on running my blood test for me. I mean, really, what even? I can do all that by myself. In any case, I wonder what experiment I should focus on next. The blue flame in the furnace outside is growing weaker by the day. I do hope that the guidance stone doesn't stop working. Day 6. My age reversal has progressed even further still. I now look and feel like a 6-year-old girl. My height has regressed so much that I can no longer reach things in high places. It's super annoying. Where is that genius swordsman we placed in the Slumber of Restoration anyway? Wake up already! If he doesn't awaken soon, my future expansions, I think that is a typo, maybe, will go to waste. And even if he does manage to wake up, how can I be sure he'll find me here? I want to go and kick Linky awake, but I doubt Simon would help me. It'd be hard with my 6-year-old body anyway. Instead, I think I'll begin working on a rune to unreverse my aging process. Day 7. This morning's exams indicated that I'm still age 6, same as yesterday. Perhaps my age reversal stopped. As luck would have it, I also have finished developing the beta version of an age-boosting rune. If successful, this should be able to reverse the effects of the anti-aging rune. I hope it will, anyway. All I need to do is increase the output and expose myself to its rays. However, when I tried to add this feature to the Sheikah slate I made, I found that the guidance stone had stopped. What's more, the blue flame in the outside furnace has gone out. I sent Simon to the ancient furnace, but he was too clumsy, and it was raining, and nothing went to plan. So I had to go down there to help. But a girl in the village saw me. What a mess I made. Not only am I unable to continue my research in this state, I can only work by the light of gas lamps. What to do? That was a substantial amount of lore. And I have no clue how many minutes we're into the episode already, but it can't be helped. Hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and welcome back to... It's over there, okay. Welcome back to The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. When we last left off, we made it to Hateno Village, and there's actually the furnace, which we need to get its blue flame in order for What's-Her-Face to do anything with us. So, let's fly over there. Oh boy, I forget this uses stamina. And I'm certain I'll be fine. Can I whistle while flying? No, okay, that'd be kind of stupid. Link just lets go both hands, but he's still flying. And he's just holding it with, like, his ear so that he can whistle. I may have to make a crash landing in the water. In fact, I don't have to. Let's do it anyway. Or do that. Oh, I can do that. No! Oh, man. I drowned. I forgot that uses stamina. That was fine, too. Well, I guess that means I have to do it again. And drop. Neat. What is this? It's a nothing. Okay. Good to know. Right, let's use my torch, which I've had for a while now. Light the blue flame. How long will this last, actually? Link. Of course. Use it again. Alright, blue flame time! I probably won't even be able to get on heart to do this. So I'll just have to run the long way. In fact, this is going to be a little bit difficult. Because I can't sheath this. I can't go into water. I can't climb. I could light stuff on fire, but that won't help anyone. And hopefully the torch will last the entire way. It's very pretty, but still. Also, there's a shrine over there, which I should probably take care of. Alright, it was this way? It was this way. Actually, I can cut back, technically, because we've been here before. So I'll meet you back at the top. Back up at the top, after a long, long walk. Where is this furnace? Is it that? At the front of the house? I think so. Hey, why to swing? Done. And that's lit now. And I can now use this as a skip travel point. Let's put this away. And actually switch over to my... Oh, I wanted to see what this looks like. Ooh. That's pretty. Cool. We now have a glowy sword. Alright, I'm back. That works now, right? You read it, didn't you? Sure. Well, I commend your honesty. Still, it is never acceptable to rummage through a young lady's private musings. Got it? Naturally, you should be punished for that. Switch on! Wait, what? What? No. 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 Don't know. Okay. 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 Yeah. Yeah. That was real funny. You got me. Let's just get this. Oh wait, I can't get the stupid room. I can't storm out of here angrily. I need her help. Snap. Linky, thank you so much. Now then, take a look over there. The guidance stone must be starting to react. There's nothing mysterious about it. This is pure science. Heh, my sweet little guidance stone. You sure know how to make this old researcher's heart flutter. Now then, let's go ahead and restore those Sheikah Slate runes for you. Give me a nice snap. Go on. No time to be shy about it. Snap? That was pretty weak, but that's okay. Okay then. Sheikah Slate repair underway. Guidance stone lock removed. Now, let's do this thing. Now they talked about basic runes. What does that even entail? Sheikah Slate authenticated, camera, Hyrule compendium, and album missing files confirmed. Camera. Oh, so I can take pictures. Okay, that's why. Also, people have translated those runes because that is, they're actually saying something. They just use a different glyph than we do. And I believe it says now loading, and then it says all your base are. So Nintendo was throwing in a little meme there with all your base are belong to us, which is great. So we got our last upgrade, and it's a camera? Now, one of those pictures I didn't recognize, so I'll have to go look at that. And the Hyrule Compendium. Neat. Repair complete. So now I can take pictures, maybe? Which is cool, I guess. And it's done. So, is it all fixed up now? Let me see here. Which one is it? Camera, Hyrule Compendium, album. Yep, looks good. So, I know this is sudden, but hear me out. Take a picture of me with the camera. Oh, and don't forget to let me see. Alright, so... would it be minus? Yes, it would be minus. Now, I actually wanted to look at a couple of these pictures. Because... a couple of them I don't recognize. None of these I recognize, actually. Okay, I recognize that one, I think. But not that one. They're preloaded. Before the destruction. That one I've definitely never been to. So, I'm guessing Link took these. Also, that looks like Gondor. Link took these before he was put to slumber. Interesting. Okay, camera? Yes, how do I take a picture, though? With this? No. Oh, duh. There. Use it like you normally would. Alright, how I zoom? Oh, that's how I zoom. Alright. Zoom in. And... snap! Save an album? Sure. Here. Snap! How's the picture taking going? Did you get a cute pic of me with the camera? Yeah, I took one. Ooh, I can't wait to see it. Let me see. My, who is this beautiful young creature? Huh? I guess that's my cue. Sorry, I kind of lost it there. It wasn't on purpose. It's not just a pretty girl in these images. Yes, there are also some old landscape photos stored in the album. I knew Princess Zelda had made frequent use of the camera feature, but this... Hey, Linky, it dawns on me that you were Princess Zelda's appointed knight, which means... there's a strong possibility that you accompanied her to all of the places where these pictures were taken. Oh, right. The lost memory thing could prove troublesome. But don't lose hope. It just means these pictures could be the missing piece to help restore your lost memories. If my hunch is correct, I suggest you check in with Impa. She knows more about Princess Zelda than even I do. Oh, yeah. There's just one more thing I need from you. You don't have to worry about this until you see Impa, but I want you to bring me back some ancient materials. Bring them either to me or to Robbie at the Akala Ancient Tech Lab. As if my joy weren't enough, if you bring me ancient materials, we'll give you something good as a reward. Alright, let's do this. Weren't you, like, gonna restore your youth and stuff? I guess I could ask about that, but you were gonna restore your youth, or your elderliness, I guess. Aha, I'm glad you asked. If you bring me some ancient materials, I'll power up your runes. Ooh, hello. You'll need 3 ancient screws, which I sold. Man. Oh, wait, okay. But I sold those. I don't have those. Cool. Neat. So I can do that. Oh, wait, but I have... This is Robbie, right? No, this is Simon. Okay, so... Can I bring her materials? Oh, I should see Impa first. Okay. Bye. Alright. Ah, door. Alright, we still have time left in the episode. Oh, wait. Before I go off blinking places and not doing a shrine, I need to do a shrine. Okay, the Mayim Agana Shrine. Let's go in. The Mayim Agana Apparatus. Okay. I have 2 places I can go to. Let's go to the low path first. Also, I just thought of something. What if these shrines start requiring that I use my sailcloth? That'll be crazy. Once they start requiring other items, like the arrows to be used, it'll get really weird. Alright, what is this apparatus that they're talking about? Ugh, long drop. Examine. Oh, it's a tilt puzzle. Alright. I can do tilt puzzles. Bring it over there, to the right. I'm glad I'm not playing this on the Wii! Oh! Because it's so realistic. Although there is a set... It is kind of desynced, but whatever. Okay, bring it over here. Ellie, over this way. Very carefully. Not let it get... Not let it build up speed here, because that happens. Ah, man. There's a chest in there as well. Do you see that? That's the secret. Alright. Third time's the charm. Go this way. Man, this is so sensitive. It's great. It's amazing to see what this technology has, how far this technology has come. Like, the smallest movements it detects. It's amazing. Alright. Now, all we need to do is bring it there. Speed it up. And... No! No! This is so close. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. No! I got it there. It's the long... We're in the long haul now. Home stretch. Tilt it a lot. And lift it up! Got it! Yes! I did it. Now all it needs to do is roll down. And while it's doing that, I can't actually stop it. How do I get that? How do I get my puzzle thing? Do I have to tilt it and then leave it? Here, let me go check that. Because that's the secret treasure that I need to grab. Maybe I could sailcloth off of that platform. That's also possible. Ready to run jump. Oh, no. Not enough. Not enough, actually. All right. Go, 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 go. Yes, I'm in. All right, now I'm in the thing. I have no clue how I'm going to get out, but I'm in, so that works. There's my chest. What's my reward? A Phrenic bow. Bow passed down through the Sheikah tribe. Concentrating before drawing the string will allow me to target distant enemies as easily as those nearby, so it's a stealth bow. And my inventory's full, of course it is. And I'm there. All right, now I can get my actual reward, which is another spirit orb. And then I can head to the tower, and everything's looking great under the sun. Also, I'm recording way more episodes than my batch would entail, just because I want to play this game more and more. Normally I would record 3 episodes, but this is my 4th, and I may record a 5th, because I would like to play this game. Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of the hero. Yeah, I know. Got a spirit orb. Alright, we're back out. Let's see if I can call over Hart so we can head over to the tower. Hart, buddy! Where is he? Over there. Let's go grab him. Oh, wait, it was the ferret! Ah, the ferret. Ran away again. And actually, before we leave, I'd like to talk to some people, because I've been running amok everywhere. And I want to talk to some people here. Whoa, you're kind of scary. Okay, I got this. Greeting time. You're a customer, right? Sure. Hi. Hun, it's a customer. Looks like he's hungry to have his clothes dyed. I'll leave it to you. Die, okay. Hey, creepy man. Welcome. If you're looking to add some color to your wardrobe, you found the right place. Hew do you do. Welcome to Kochi's Dye Shop, where we live to dye. If you have any dye ingredients, it's 20 rupees to dye an item. That includes our service charge, of course. Let's get going and dye your getup so you can change the color. Okay. No. I'm sorry, but you don't have 20 rupees. Come back some other time. Okay, so I can dye clothes here. Interesting. Alright, let's talk to some more people and enter some houses. I think the rest of this episode will just be spent talking to people, and then we can go to Impa after that. Talking to people and getting to that tower, because that'll also give me a skip travel location. And also breaking into people's houses. You have anything for me to steal? No? Okay, bye. The door pushed me out. What's up here? Also, it seems like everyone has twins now. You notice that? All the kids are in pairs, except for that one, I guess. Although, presumably he has a twin somewhere. It's true, I really saw her. Their faces are really weird here. I mean, I'm not racist. Hey, sorry, who did you see? There's a girl staying up at the Hateno. Yes, I know. I saw her come outside. She was right over there. It's true. But when I tried to tell a grown-up about it, they said the only people who've lived there is an old man and an old woman. But she was a Sheikah girl, I swear. No one ever listens to kids. Hey, sir. Are you an adventurer? I'm the head of Hateno Village. Call me Reed. Why are you in my house? Isn't this a beautiful, peaceful place we have here, don't you think? Yes, we're finally feeling a bit of recovery from the great calamity. Our village is pleasant, peaceful, and has plenty of food to go around. Please stay as long as you'd like. Glad to know I'm welcome to break into houses. Wait. Chest? No. Hey, woman. Hi. Evening. You look like a traveler type to me. There's something I've been waiting to show to an adventurous soul, but I can't do it when it's raining like this. Okay. Bye, I'll come back later. See, is there anyone else to talk to? This village is huge, so I doubt I'll talk to everyone the first pass. Is there no one here? There's a ladle. It apparently does a ton of damage. Why? Yeah, I don't want it, because I'm not a thief, even though I've been talking about stealing from everyone. Hey, can I steal from you? There are mushrooms under his house. Hello. Even in the rain, you still gotta check everyone out. Ever stayed at the Tunpu Inn? No. If you're not staying there, then I suppose I'm supposed to check out everyone who comes to town. Sounds weird. Your job is weird. Whatever it is you do. I know things have been peaceful recently, but the outside world is still pretty dangerous, yeah? So I gotta check it and make sure if any beauties, I mean, suspicious folks have come around here. Beauties? If you're lucky enough to stay at the Tunpu Inn, you'll see what I mean. Say hello to Prima for me, if you do, or Prima. Not that she even knows who I am. This is tough. I have to give her something. What kind of gift do you think Prima at the Tunpu Po In would want. Just take a guess. It's not for me, you understand. It's for my buddy's friend. What is it? Do you know Prima? That's Miss Prima to you. You ever been to the inn here? Oh, it's right there. Okay, I was gonna go the opposite direction. But I'm glad he told me. Prima is the clerk over at the Tunpu Inn. This is tough. I have to give her something. You need anything else? No, not right now. I'll actually go into the inn real quick. Just to see what it's like. Check out this Prima girl. Also, there are no loading screens. Hey, is that you? That's her. Thanks for coming here in the rain. Welcome to Tunpu Inn. A regular bed is 20, or if you're looking for a more relaxing and restorative mind and body experience, you can have one of our extra soft downy beds for 40 rupees. No, I'm fine. Come back in soon. It appears I can't talk to her normally. There's a shield. Huh. Okay, well, we can do that quest later. I keep saying later for everything, but also we're still in the beginning of the game, so it's understandable. Okay, before I end that off the episode, since I feel like I've done a fair job talking to everyone, let's head over to go get a heart, and then we can head to the tower, and then end the episode. Oh, there he is. Hey, buddy. It's been a while. All right. I need to head to a high place, actually. Alright, we're on the road again, heading towards that tower. Then we can head to, whatchamacallit, the Kakariko Village. Come on, buddy. We're not in the town. You can run. Guess he doesn't want to run. That is actually kind of far away. But I think we can make it in this episode. Come on, buddy. Head up. Oh, I know it's difficult. But I can see a path that we can take. We're not in a village. You can run. You're good. Also, let me check to make sure Link's not cold. No, he's fine. Okay. There we go. Oh! That's a little bit steep for you. His handling isn't that good. He does not like turning. Of course, neither did Licorice. Alright, be careful. Don't fall down a precipice. We should make it there in record time. Also, we're what, like 12 episodes in at this point? 10? And I haven't really talked about my feelings for this game. Because stuff has been happening that I've had to concentrate on. But so far, I'm actually enjoying it quite a bit. Oh, there's a fox! Where's the tower? Where's the tower? Wait, whoa, stop. Where'd the tower go? There we go. Now I'm on the right path. So far, I would say I'm satisfied. Albeit a little bit overwhelmed with how many new areas we've explored and how much there is in the game. But still, I'm excited to see how this is going to play out. I've spent many a time. Can I actually get here? Whoa, boy. I've spent many a number of hours talking with my friends about what the ideal, like the perfect Zelda game would be. We've spent many hours talking about that. Me and Dave, people at the college, just anyone you could think of. And when we boiled down to it, Dave put this rather well. He said, if you can walk around and find a potato on the ground and eat it, and pull it up out of the ground and eat it, Nintendo has truly outdone themselves. And, oh, hello. Now, while that's kind of joking, it stands to reason. Like I said, we've talked about this quite a bit. That's a huge fortress right there. And if the game is open world enough, this was the conclusion that we came to. If the game is open world enough, what is that shadow? Looks like actually something. Oh, it's the tower. Oh, it's the tower. The tower makes that shadow. That's so cool. So, originally, we jokingly described the perfect Zelda game as having 6 discs, a couple $100 of paid DLC, hundreds of bosses, multiple endgame antagonists, which your story choices can affect whether or not they meet and possibly defeat each other or join forces, and about 50 different versions of Goma, 50 different copies. Like I said, it was joking, but the concept is there. The open world concept of the game was what we wanted, was what everyone I've talked to... Ooh, this is covered in spines. Can I even climb this? Tano Tower. This thing is absolutely coated in spines. Come on, Link, run up. So, when this game was announced... Oh, that's a test of stamina. Let me drop real quick. When this game came out, and they announced that it was going to be open world, and you could go into dungeons in any order, and there were a bunch of them, I leapt for joy, because that was exactly what I wanted in a Zelda game. And so far, this game has been... Breath of the Wild has been verbatim what I wanted to see in a Zelda title. Can I make it to the top here? Yeah, I think I can. So far I'm pleased. I mean, it will depend on how the story is going to play out. I was not pleased when I heard that Ganon was the antagonist. I was not pleased at all, because one of the reasons why I like Skyward Sword is because Ganon isn't the antagonist. To me, he's kind of a cop-out for trying to flesh out an actual antagonist with reasons for being bad other than, I wanna rule the world. And I feel like other villains, like Gurahim or Majora, have been that. They've had character development. They've, maybe not Majora, but they've been unique and memorable. And Ganon is memorable, but solely because he's in every Zelda game, almost. And I feel like I was not pleased when Ganon was announced, but I still have high hopes, and even if the story is trash, I will still be happy if the gameplay continues to be as good as this. So far, I would say this is a good Zelda game. Also, wait a minute. I'm surprised I did not take damage there, honestly. Okay, so what I need to do is go up, and then circle down and around. And then hopefully we should be able to... Oh wait, no, I can go this way. Okay. Then hopefully we can make it to the top of Catcall Tower, and get our stray bead, and also learn catwalk. In fact, I can jump to the side. Almost to the top. This is really just kind of a test of stamina. I wonder if I hadn't gotten the stamina boost, if I wouldn't be able to do this. I feel strongly that I wouldn't, at least not for that first climb. Alright, can I make it to the top from here? Yes, I can. I wonder if other towers will also be difficult like this. Almost up at the top. It's in sight. In fact, I could probably jump at this point. I have enough stamina, and I know that I can reach it, that I can waste a little bit to jump. And we're up to the top. Let's distill that rune, get some information on the area, and fill it out in our map. Sheikah Tower activated. I see another shrine. From here. Scanning area. And distilling the rune. All your base are belong to us. I wonder how that feels on Link's face and skin when that splashes like that. Maybe it's just light and it's kind of an illusion. Whoa! That is a big area that we're actually in right now. I didn't realize. It's also very mountainous. All right. Next time, I think we may head... Well, let's see. Let's place a marker there. And then look at it on our map. How far away is that? Where did I place that marker? Actually, where am I? I'm right here. Actually? Oh. Oh, wow. That's where we were episode before last. That's the shrine next to the stable. Wow, how far we have come. Wait a minute. Mount Lanayru. And there's a sea next to it. Oh man. I hope that there's a connection, which I've been hoping every episode. All right. Thank you guys so much for watching. Next time, I actually would like to go to a shrine, which there's one on atop that mountain. So we may go there. I would like to go to another shrine before visiting. There's also one over there. Before visiting Impa again, because I would like to get an upgrade, hopefully hearts. And yeah, next time we're going to be doing that. I release new episodes of Breath of the Wild every Monday and Wednesday. I'm also Let's Playing Pikmin 2 right now, and you can catch episodes of that every Tuesday and Thursday. And if you enjoyed this episode in any capacity, please click like. If you didn't, then drop a comment telling me I could make the next episode so that you would like it. I'll see you guys for the next episode of Breath of the Wild. Cute little guy. If you freeze them with Ultra Bitter Spray, man, there's so many bomb rocks! What is this? If you use... I'm going to try to sail to that shrine. Even though it's above the water, and I do not like water, I'm going to try to do it. And if I can't, and I can't swim back, well, at least I have skip travel and can skip travel back to that shrine.